Welcome to A&M Awesome Animals!
Hello, everyone. Today I'll be comparing two amazing dog breeds, the Scottish Terrier and the Minter Schnauzer. Please don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos. Scotties were originally bred in the Highlands of Scotland. The actual origin of a breed as old as the Scottish Terrier is obscure and undocumented. Minter Schnauzers were originally bred to be ratters and guard dogs on farms. They were developed in the mid to late 19th century in Germany by crossbreeding the standard Schnauzer with smaller breeds, such as the Minter Pinscher, Affenpinscher, and perhaps the Poodle or Pomeranian. The original purpose of the Minter Schnauzer was to catch rats on farms. Today, however, the Minter Schnauzer's main mission in life is to bring companionship and joy to the people fortunate enough to live with this cheerful dog. Historically, the Scottie was bred by farmers to help them manage vermin problems. They would follow prey such as badgers, foxes, and other vermin right into their burrow and then try to dig them out. Such breeds of dogs are known as earth dogs. Scottish Terriers do well in earth dog trials, which are a simulated hunt. The Scottish Terrier can suffer from a number of genetic health problems. They include cataracts, progressive retinal atrophy, neurological problems, brain cancer, bladder stones, Cushing's disease, hypothyroidism, von Willebrand's disease, hemophilia, and deafness. Minter Schnauzers can suffer from health problems that include allergies, epilepsy, diabetes, and pancreatitis. The most genetic problem in the breed is a strong tendency to form different types of bladder stones, usually stravite or calcium oxalate stones. The first point is a tie. Scotties have a temperament different from other dog breeds and might not be always suitable for every family. They may be difficult to train, like their own space, do not tolerate small children, and have their own ideas about how your household should run. Usually, Minter Schnauzers house train relatively easily as they can be quite fastidious. But your young dog will need direction and opportunities. Teach your Minter Schnauzer basic commands like come, sit, and stay, using rewards like treats and play. Start with simple requests or only short sessions. The second point will go to the Minter Schnauzer. Scottish Terriers raised with children are suitable as a family pet, but the breed may not be always recommended for small children or kids who do not have experience with dogs. However, when properly socialized with children, Scotties happily act as a protector on their behalf. Minter Schnauzers are hardy, alert, spunky little dogs. They can be feisty and may put on a show of scrappiness when confronted by dogs they do not know. The playfulness of Minter Schnauzers makes them ideal for families with well-behaved children. The next point goes to the Minter Schnauzer. The Scottish Terrier is a small dog that measures 10 inches tall. The males of the breed weigh 19 to 22 pounds, while the females weigh 18 to 21 pounds. The American Kennel Club does not recognize dogs smaller than this as a miniature Scottish Terrier. Scotties are similar in size to the miniature Schnauzer. Miniature Schnauzers are 12 to 14 inches tall, slightly taller than the Scottie, and weigh 11 to 20 pounds, which is slightly less than the Scottie. This point is a tie. Scottish Terriers have a short, medium coat with minimal shedding. However, their coat requires a moderate amount of maintenance, such as brushing and trimming. Minter Schnauzers are a low-shedding breed with a double coat that require above-average grooming care. A regular slicker brush is all you need for the day-to-day brushing, but you will need to clip or hand-strip his coat every 5 to 8 weeks. This point will go to the Scottish Terrier. Chris Sheffield, who adopted Toddy in 1999, has lost his wife and his kids. They have flown the nest, but Toddy is still going strong 22 years later. Toddy the Terrier is a strong contender for being Scotland's oldest pooch. The aging Cairn turns 22 this autumn, which is staggering 103 in dog years. The average lifespan for Scotties is 12 to 15 years. The average lifespan of Minter Schnauzers is 11.7 years, which is similar to the average of 12 years for dogs overall. This point goes to the Scottish Terrier. Scotties are fairly active and will need at least one decent-sized walk every day. As traditional hunters, they may become distracted by other animals that they mistake for prey. So it's a good idea to walk your Scottie on the lead until you get to an area that's nice and remote. The Kennel Club recommends up to an hour of exercise a day for Scotties. Don't be fooled by their short legs, they love a good long walk. With Schnauzers originally being used as working dogs, the Minter Schnauzer has fairly high energy levels and requires at least an hour of exercise every day according to the Kennel Club. They could be classed down as a lap dog breed, but will need a good run around before sitting down to enjoy a good book with you. This point is a tie. Certain breeds, such as miniature schnauzers, are more predisposed to excessively oily skin, resulting in a unique smell and greasy feel when touched. This can be treated with certain shampoos and topical medications. When in doubt, if you notice that your dog is starting to smell, start with a bath. Scottish Terriers have no more doggy smell than any other breed. The last point will go to the Scottish Terrier. These dogs are great family pets and are extremely intelligent, but the Scottish Terrier won this battle. Miniature Schnauzer fans, don't be disappointed. Better luck next time.
If you've enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos. See you guys next time, good bye!